Good morning.
Good morning.
Congrats to Missionary Baptist Church.
Yes.
Families, friends, and guests, welcome. Please join me in our call to worship. Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you and praise your name. For in perfect faithfulness, you have done wonderful things planned long ago. Open the gates that the righteous name may enter. The nation that keeps faith, you will keep in perfect peace. Those who mind are steadfast because they trust in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord himself is the rock eternal. We will now have prayer by Elijah Johnson, followed by Rosalind Hill.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, our kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, as we forgive our debtors, and deliver us from temptation, but deliver us from evil. God is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
To the book of Lamentations. Lamentations chapter 3. I would encourage you to don't be ashamed to use your table of contents. That's what it's in there for. Lamentations chapter 3. Verses 21 through 23. Lamentations chapter 3, verses 21, 22, and 23. This I recall to my mind, therefore I have hope. Through the Lord's mercies we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. This I recall to my mind, therefore I have hope. Through the Lord's mercies we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. I want to use for a subject, therefore, I have hope. Therefore, I have hope. In this book of Lamentations, which probably took you a little longer to find this morning, we see some verses that are the focus and the motivation of a song that we sing and that we hear quite often in church. And we may not know these words from the Bible, but we do know them from the hymn. And on this Sunday, as we continue to cross over through the waters of this pandemic and this virus, I just want to remind us and tell us again that hope changes everything. Yes. Hope changes everything. Yes. And this book of Lamentations is exactly what the name declares and signifies, because it's a long lament. It's a scripture of sorrow. It's a book of the blues. If you weren't lamenting and sorrowful and had the blues before you read Lamentations, you will when you finish. Because in this book of Lamentations, the prophet Jeremiah, who believed wrote these words, has taken a step back to reflect and to think about the Babylonian destruction of Jerusalem. And he thinks about the Babylonians when they come into Jerusalem and they have taken over the city, and all the death, all the destruction, all the deportation that he has seen. So he looks at the fact that these Babylonians have come into Israel and how they've been in a pandemic and a virus in the land, because nobody's home was unaffected. Nobody's life was protected. Nobody's job was safe. And nobody's family was unarmed. And even in the temple where the children of Israel would go to worship God, it had been shut down. And they couldn't worship like they used to. So the Babylonians were Israel's version of Omicron, Delta, and Alpha. And they were a virus that touched and changed everything in their lives. And as Jeremiah is looking back over everything that has happened, he shares with us one of the most discouraging and the most painful verses in all the Bible. Because when Jeremiah is thinking about what has happened, he says that I can't believe this is happening to us. Because who would have ever thought that the temple would be shut down? Who would have ever thought that we would have to live like this? Who would have ever thought that our land will be where we are right now? And Jeremiah says in chapter 3, verse 51, that when I think about everything that I've seen, that it brings suffering to my soul. And I believe that there's somebody here this morning, and somebody who's watching online, that has had some verse 31 happen in your life. Because who would have thought 3 years ago that we would be where we are right now? Who would have thought that a worldwide virus was right around the corner? Who would have thought that the doors of the church would be shut and it would be worshiping the Lord on our phones and on our computers and in our homes? And y'all, when I think about where our nation is, and when I think about where we are as a people, and when I think about what we've gone through, it brings suffering to my soul. Because it hurts my soul to think about how many people have lost their lives to COVID, but we still argue about being vaccinated and wearing a mask. It hurts my soul to see racism and white privilege running wild through the halls of our government and running wild in the streets that we walk on. It hurts my soul to see that Black Lives Matter protesters are called rioters and thugs, but the people who rebelled against the Capitol are called patriots and lawyers. It hurts my soul to know that we have a government that can give us a Juneteenth holiday, but can't pass the John Lewis Voting Rights Act. It hurts my soul to know that women's bodies are still being represented by Southern conservative men. It hurts my soul to see our senior citizens have to decide between medical care and healthy food. It hurts my soul to see Black men being incarcerated in jail and innocence, but other races are freed and let off in their guilt. Because whoever would have believed that this would happen? And y'all, it hurts my soul. And in the middle of talking about everything that hurts his soul, Jeremiah says something that messed me up. Because he says something that almost out of place in the book of mourning and in the book of weeping. Because in verse 21, Jeremiah says that this I recall to mind, and therefore I have hope. And y'all, to me, hope seems to be inappropriate in the middle of mourning. Hope to me seems to be out of place when you're sad and you're sorrow. Hope to me doesn't belong in a book about lamenting and grieving. And Jeremiah uses the word hope. And hope seems to mean to have some expectation. It seems to mean to be optimistic. It seems to mean to anticipate or to wait for. So Jeremiah said there's some things that I remember that make me wait for something else to come. Because no matter how bad it's been, and no matter how much we've seen, no matter what we've gone through, Jeremiah declares that I still have hope. And every now and again, when we look at what's happening in our land, we need to remind ourselves of the reason that we have hope. Because we don't have hope, we don't give in to darkness at the present. And we don't surrender to anything that's been said. But we stand fast in our faith, and we believe that something better is about to come. And I want to encourage somebody this morning to hold on to your hope. Because I know that you're still dealing with COVID, but hold on to your hope. I know that things are jacked up in the Supreme Court, but hold on to your hope. And I know that sometimes it is too much to bear, but can I propose to us this morning that we still have hope? Because listen to what Jeremiah has remembered that gives us hope in the middle of darkness. Because he says in verse 22, that through the Lord's mercies we are not consumed. So Jeremiah says that when I look back at everything that I've gone through, and when I see the devastation of our land, when I see what the enemy has done, when I see that what we've gone through and what I never thought we'd go through, when I realize the pain that we had to live in, he says that I come to one undeniable conclusion, and that the only reason that we're still alive is because God's mercies haven't let go of us. Because one thing that this pandemic should have taught us and shown us is that the only reason that we're here right now is because of God's mercy. And I don't know who I'm talking to, but I want you to know that it wasn't your degree that got you through this pandemic. It's not who you have on speed dial. It's not how much money you earn. It's not how smart you think you are. It wasn't Pfizer or Moderna. It wasn't N95 or N99. But the only reason that we're standing here today is because the mercies of God put a hedge around our lives. And all of us should know this morning that if it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be? And y'all know that I grew up in church. And I'm a son of a Baptist preacher. So y'all, I went to church all my life. So I got to be honest with y'all. That growing up as a child, that I hated some of the sayings and the quotes that I heard in church. And I didn't like how somebody always got up and they would say that God is good all the time. I didn't like when the preachers just got up and shouted that he'll never put more on you than you can bear. And one of the sayings that I didn't like the most is when the preacher would say, if it had not been for the Lord on my side. And y'all, one of the reasons I didn't like that saying is I thought it was a lazy way of the preacher to get people to shout. So I didn't like hearing that as a child. But y'all, as I've grown up, and I've lived through my own stuff, and I've grown through my own ups and downs, I found out some things. And I found out that God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. And I learned I had to carry some burdens on my own. I learned that God will never put more on that you can bear. And now that I've been in the pandemic, I understand how shaky life can be. And now that I see that my education and my degree can't save me, I have come to the conclusion that if it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be? So y'all, we can have hope because God's mercies have kept us. Then Jeremiah says in verse 23 that they are new every morning. So y'all, every morning when I wake up, I'm walking in brand new mercy. And because of that, Jeremiah tells us that we are not consumed. So because God's mercies are new every morning, we are not consumed. And that word consumed means to be finished. So let me give you the Elkanah Fuller translation. So because God's mercies are new every morning, it's not over yet. Because the Lord wakes us up every day, the story is not done. I don't know who needs to hear this, but if the Lord woke you up this morning, and if the Lord started you on your way, and if God is giving you another chance, that must mean that God is not finished with me yet. Tell somebody it's not over. That was the wrong somebody. Now tell yourself it's not over. And I just believe it because God's mercy is a new every morning, that we still have hope. Because verse 22 tells us that his compassions fail not. So now I need to give y'all some good news. Because the Lord has never given up on you. And somebody other than me ought to be happy about that this morning. Because God has never given up on you. Because his compassions fail not. And Jeremiah looks at the events of his day. And y'all, he comes to this conclusion. That some of the things that we've gone through, that some of it we brought on ourselves. Because Israel is destroyed because of our sins. And we have to deal with the enemy because of our unfaithfulness to God. But y'all, in the middle of all of that, the Lord has never been unfaithful to us. So as much as I have failed God, God has never failed me. As much as I have strayed away from God, God has never strayed away from me. As many times as I turn my back on God, God has never turned his back on me. And let me tell y'all what that's a word. Because all of us have some limits and some boundaries on how much you're going to deal with from other people. And I don't care how much you love your boo or your baby. But there's a limit in the boundary where I can't deal with you no more. But there's some boundaries I can't cross. And you can push me to my limit. And you force me to walk away. And as easy it was for us to walk away from other people, God looks at us and he says that I will never leave you or forsake you. So y'all, no matter what you're dealing with in this life, God is still with you. And his hand is still on you. And his presence is still by your side. And his love and his mercy and concern and his compassion and still has his hand on you. And y'all, how is it that God has no limitations? How is it that God has no boundaries when it comes to dealing with our mess? Because on a hill far away, on a little rugged cross, and on that cross, a songwriter says that Jesus paid it all, and all to him I owe, because my sin had left the crimson stain, but he washed it white as snow. So y'all, because of Christ, God has no limits and no boundaries of dealing with us. And he'll forgive our sins. He'll restore our lives. He'll keep his hands on us. Because Jesus paid it all. And his compassion fail not. So now we need to know that that word compassion in Hebrew is the plural form of a noun that means womb. W-O-M-B. So y'all, in this context, compassion means womb. So here's what Jeremiah recognizes. That in the middle of that Babylonian pandemic, that God has covered us in his womb and has taken us into his womb. Now, if you don't know what a womb is, it's where a baby is nurtured. It's where a baby gets the nutrients that they need. It's where a baby is protected and stretched until it's ready to be born. So, y'all, Jeremiah says that in the middle of all this, that the Lord covered us in his womb. God is developing us in his womb. And that God is nurturing us in his womb. Because over the last 3 years, all of us have gone through some struggles. But some things should be strong in our lives. Because yes, we've had some ups and downs. But the Lord has developed us in some ways that couldn't have happened without this pandemic. Because by now, we should have lost just a little bit of weight. By now, we should have gotten our finances together. By now, our prayer life should be a little bit stronger. By now, there should be some more underlying pages in your Bible. By now, we should have told some more people how good God is. Because during this pandemic, the Lord has strengthened us and covered us in the middle of our struggle. But y'all, not only does the word compassion mean womb, but in Hebrew, nouns have gender attached to them. So in Hebrew, nouns can be masculine, feminine, or neutral. So compassion means womb, but it's in masculine gender. Now y'all don't miss this, because womb is masculine. And what you ought to be asking yourself right about now is, how in the world can a womb be masculine? And I don't be some woman rolling your eyes right now and raising your hand in objection. Because ain't no way that a womb is masculine. Because a womb has to be feminine. But y'all, in these things, womb is masculine. And y'all, that shouldn't be. That just shouldn't happen. Because how can we be developed in a context that doesn't make any sense? Because womb and masculine don't go together. But here we have a God developing us in a situation that shouldn't exist. But y'all, here's how we know that we can have hope. Because when we can look back over our life and see that God is prospering us in some contrary situation. And I can tell that God is growing you when you should be dying. When you see that God is blessing you in a situation that ought to be troubling you. When you get the job but you don't have the right resume. When you're the supervisor and they have the degree. When you're being blessed when you ought to be taken out. Is there anybody here this morning who knows what it's like for the Lord to bless you in some hostile situations and in some unpleasant conditions, and that God has blessed me in spite of where I am? When you can look back at everything that said no, but God said yes. When you can look back at everything that said death, but God says life. When you can look at the labels and the stereotypes that they said was going to be your destiny, but the Lord's ordering your steps into something bigger and something better. That's when you know that you can have hope. That's all I got, y'all. But here's how I know that I can have hope. Because it's of God's mercies that we are done. Here's how I know we can have hope. Because his compassions fail not. Then Jeremiah closed with some words that I want to leave with you. Because he says in verse 23, and great is thy faithfulness. So y'all, Jeremiah looks around. And he says, this is what I know, that God is faithful. I came out and dropped that on somebody today. And I want you to write it down and make it your next tattoo. Because God is faithful. God is faithful. And somebody today has lived long enough to know that. That God would do what he said he would do. That all things work together for those who love God. That the sufferings of this present age are not worthy to be compared to the glory which shall be revealed in us. That if God be for us, that he's more than the world against us. That weeping may endure for a night, but that joy comes in the morning. Because notice what Jeremiah says. He says, great is thy faith. And that word thou suggests something to us. Because when Jeremiah says, great is thy faith, y'all, something is going on. Because when he says that the Lord's mercies we are not consumed, he's talking to Israel. When he says, because his compassions fail not, he's talking to his people. But y'all, when he says, great is thy faith, Jeremiah changes his audience. And he ain't talking to them. When he says, great is thy faith, because thou is God. So Jeremiah has decided that I'm going to tell God how faithful he is. I'm going to tell God how good he is. I'm going to tell God how merciful he is. I'm going to tell God how great he is. Goodbye, progressive. And may the Lord bless you real good. But here's how we know we can have hope. Because when you made the decision that in the middle of my struggle, that I'm still going to tell God about God. That even in a pandemic, that I'm still going to wake up on a Sunday morning and tell God that you've been good to me. Tell God that you made a way for me. Tell God that your love has blessed me. Tell God how thankful you are for what he's done. Is there anybody here this morning who can just say, great is your faithfulness? And I'm going to tell God how great he is. Because we can have hope because the Lord's mercies are not consumed. We can have hope because his compassions fail not. And y'all, we can have hope because great is thy faithfulness. God bless you.